thoughts, Mega Man? What do you think?
I expect to see Kinguin actually take Cobblestone on this one. I think that they play this map more regularly. This is going to be their bread and butter right here. Gambit, they're decent on this map, but they've had some struggles on it in the past, and it's going to come down to a matter of synergy. And with this being a relatively newer lineup, with Zeus just coming in, I don't know if they're going to have the synergy necessary for this map. Kinguin, they've shown us some pretty awesome stuff on it in the past, but it's going to all boil down to how Gambit show up on this one. And I've got the vetoes in front of me. Kinguin choosing Cobblestone, Nuke being scratched right off. Cash being scratched off from the Gambit side. They know that Kinguin favor that. That's probably their best map. Dust 2 is going to be map number 2. Mirage is map number 3. And if we need to go to a fourth map, it will be Train. So that's interesting. Gambit does have a one-map advantage into this best of 5, just so that you guys know. So they could still 2-0 this. We'll find out once we get Rocket and Roland. But this veto is going to be interesting. Kinguin actually opting to play Mirage against Gambit. That's going to be fascinating. If we get that far.
Well, we saw Gambit play, I wouldn't say a shaky Cobblestone, but it wasn't a fantastic Cobblestone against Fnatic Academy. It was really close. So I think it's a good choice from Kinguin. I think it's a very good map choice, actually, against Gambit. And also, Kinguin are quite good on this map. So it's a good start for them. Like you said, Mirage, interesting decision by Kinguin. And Train, if it gets to that, would be very, very interesting. I'm giving this to Kinguin.
Yeah, I'm also going to give this to Gambit.
I wouldn't say. I think it'd be quite close. 16-13, something like that.
No, I'm going with Gambit.
Going with Gambit on this. I'm going to go with 16-12 in favor of Kinguin on this map. The only thing that I could think of is that they might have the onset stages of fatigue starting to creep up on them, but they aren't going to be able to pick up the first kill, so Spiro is going to be on the board. He's going to be able to take Doja off the map, and if we've ever seen anybody lurk hard as hell on this map, it's typically Doja over towards that A-bomb site. But look at this, Spiro, he's not done fighting here in middle. He's still taking the battle to him, and he's got to be careful because he's running low on ammo now.
And the problem is he's been taking that fight for ages, and he has done basically nothing. He's found himself one kill onto Doja, but the amount of opportunities he's had to find frags, he has wasted. And that's just going to be Gambit moving forward. Mo opens it up, takes down Spero, and now that A-bomb site completely weakened, it's going to be up to Mihu to try and hold off this push, but they're slowing it down now. It's looking like it could be an A-split towards the dropper, but now with that bomb moving back over, I feel like this is going to be a B hit nice and late into the round. 45 seconds remain, and they have the advantage. They have that 4v4.
A very interesting decision made by Spero to go again and lose that lose the man advantage that the CTs have. And now it will be a very fast B push here from Gambit. They've completely switched it around. Entry frag as well. And with three men remaining, the CTs have to try and hold. They're already rotated. They've got one person over in dropper as well, but he's going to be smoked off. Mao or Mu with a kill on Ferlin. And Mihu returns, but it's just up to Rala now in a 1v3 with the bomb planted. He won't be able to do much. There's the round for Gambit.
Yeah, there you go. So Gambit able to pick that up, and that was a good read from Gambit. They actually pulled the rotation off of that B bomb site, left only one player in the back lines. That was Mao's. That was on that back platform. He couldn't get it done. He had an opportunity at a couple of kills, but he missed the player that got close on the broken wall side. So unfortunately for him, he falls. That opens up that B bomb site, and Gambit are able to just roll on in, find that pistol round victory. Now they're going to start to farm up some money. Adren and Hobbit going on the MAC-10s. Doja on the SMG as well. The UMP in hand and two AKs to bolster that. Kinguin not really invested too terribly much into this. They didn't get a lot of kills into that last round, so they're gonna just go for a pretty laid back buy. I love this angle from Mo though. Wow.
Yeah, it's not very good craftsmanship though by the people that built the castle, is it?
There's no way that, how would you even see that from the CT side?
No, I don't think you would. It's often you see it used by an AWP because, you can get through the angle and really see through the other side, but I guess an AK works too, and it's not gonna pay off this round, but I mean, Kinguin shouldn't really be getting much out of this, and that's what we're going to be seeing. Doja with a nice little kill. Like you say, he loves to have a bit of a lurk, but it should be quite easy to read into that. I mean, Kinguin, they've seen that Doja's over towards that A bomb site, and especially on this kind of round, a complete eco, they should be reading that pretty quickly. It's going to be Gambit taking themselves the round. It's just Ferdinand and Rallan. I read that's Rattlesnake for some reason. It's not Rallan.
Does this mean right now Kinguin are going to go for a force buy on the third round?
A quick look at Tab would be able to tell us, but I know that Mal's actually bought body armor into this round, so it's highly unlikely that they're going to do that. They're going to play it safe. The reason that they didn't invest too much into this is because they want to get the AWP into the hands of Spiro as fast as they possibly can. He's going to be going toe-to-toe with Mo, and that's going to be very difficult. I mean, Mo was on point yesterday. We saw the way that they were playing on Overpass. We saw the way that he was being able to lock things down, especially when they had that marathon match against Kinguin in double overtime. And that's pretty much what it's going to take. I mean, they need to have all of the smokes, all of the nades, everything that they could possibly use, and they need to be able to put those to use. And that's what's going to be important for Kinguin moving forward. So it should be a full save. We might see an upgraded pistol or two out of this, but they're going to be trying to play this one as smart as they possibly can.
Yeah, like you said, there's no money to be going for a buy on Kinguin. They are just playing it safe, making sure they get that AWP straight out because it's going to be so, so key. But the economy on Gambit is going to be absolutely monstrous unless some frags are found. They're going with an A bombsite stack. That's not going to pay off too nicely because Gambit are all pressuring towards that B bombsite and they've got the lurks over towards A. This is exactly what Gambit need. Get the bomb on B while you farm up those frags over towards A. The only problem is if they get taken down, they need to keep money alive to fight off Kinguin because they're playing a very, very safe early game. They're going to have a lot of money to boot, and that could be dangerous. But, I mean, zero players dying on the last round. They're going to be looking to keep all alive this time because they've got a very, very nice close on this map. I don't see anything Kinguin can get out of this.
The biggest thing is for Kinguin to not give up any deaths to any of these SMGs to allow Gambit to roll on the money early in this half. You saw at the beginning of the round, I believe it was Spiro had $3,200 or $3,400, yep. So he should have no problem getting the AWP into the first gun round. Should be able to get body armor and maybe even some utility behind that. But Kinguin, I mean, they're doing a good job of all staying alive and consolidated over towards long. Might be able to go for some trades, but here come the SMGs. They're going to start hunting them down. And Spiro, around the corner, they are going to check that, find that opening pick, and this is where things get really dangerous for the boys on Kinguin. They're going to start giving up some deaths to this. That's $1,200 for a Dren, another $600 for Hobbit, $600 more for Doja. So these SMGs, they're just throw the SMGs at them, let them go, and see what they can farm up. And that's really what they're doing now. They've found every single player that's on the CT side. They're looking to shut them down. And at this point, there's nothing to really stop them.
Alzidia can take that MAC-10. They are very, very happy. He can take that. He's going to have to bin it anyway.
Oh, look at the money on the T side.
Yeah, it's insane. They're already getting themselves up around that 10K marker. And that is a crazy thing to say when you're on round number three. That's pretty crazy stuff. The AWP, however, is going to be coming up for both sides. Hobbit, the only man holding onto the UMP, just bolstering that economy. If he can find a kill with it, or even survive the round, there is zero problems whatsoever for Gambit if they win this round. Like, they're going to be really happy.
Yeah. And you know what? Now, looking at the last game they played together, I'm still confused how Cobblestone went through the veto.
For Kinguin to be able to pick and Gambit not to ban.
I mean, they ban cash, which they not always do. They don't play it. And
that's when banned by Kinguin.
And also Kinguin are good enough. But Overpass was removed by Kinguin last time. And this time round, I think it was pick. It wasn't banned. So they just picked the remaining map. So,
well, let's think about it this way,
too. They just picked Train. And I think that was Gambit's pick, which, fair enough, I guess. They played Train and beat them 16-10. So probably more suitable pick than Overpass. But here we have it. It's the first full buy round here for Kinguin. And like you said, they've saved up good money after having two Ecos with an AWP on Spur. On the other hand, Gambit, they're also swimming in the dollars. Mid control here by Adren and dropped down from Dropper. Nobody saw him. This is very dangerous now for the CTs.
This is awful. He's going to get all the way into the backside of the APC. He's going to be able to backstab Spiro, who spent all that time saving up for that AWP, and they have got to be pissed on the Kinguin side that he was able to just do that.
But Mihu finding himself a kill is a saving grace, but it's quickly stolen away. Adren finds one more kill on that, I guess you could call it a lurk position, but he is now in the site. So 2 versus 3 retake, you would say, is doable, but I don't see this happening. No. There's no utility to play with. That can be said for both sides, but at the end of the day, Gambit, they're getting themselves into good positions already. Rallying going to be pushing forward here. He's going to get the angle and take down Mu. So now 1 versus 2, potentially a chance, but Adren finding Malzinho. He's 1 versus 2, and he is in between a rock and a hard place. And, yeah. I mean, the rock is going to swing at him and take his head clean out of his shoulders.
I mean, players these days are getting bare confident with the AWP, just running in front, like, yeah. Mo and Rallying, just, yeah, I'm just going to shotgun you with the AWP. Again, I don't know why Mo, like, was that close and holding that angle when he had an AWP on him, but they went around anyway, so
probably thought they were going to save in that situation. I mean, 3v2, bomb planted at A, full control, full infiltration from the back lines from Adren. He ends up getting 4 kills. He's 8-1, right? He's holding 2 kills per round right now for Gambit, and that's scary because if Adren is firing on all cylinders, Mo's hitting those entries as well, then that's going to be a really, really difficult spot for you to be in. Sorry, they're showing the credits for PGL Minor, and they actually listed Lecro as player.
Why isn't he a rifler?
He doesn't have a role in the team. He's a player. Look, Valde's a player as well.
We're all players.
Dead Fox is a player.
I'm a player. Bloody hell. Why is Dead Fox playing on Hellraisers? I thought he was Swedish.
Oscar left the team.
Because that's, you know, old news. I think, what, he joined them like a few weeks ago?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That seems like an odd arrangement. Anyway.
Sorry, mate.
Zantarez, last letter. Not
thought
bold.
That was my little wires messing about.
I'm all over the place right now.
Yeah, so another eco here by Kingwin. Mao's buying armor once more, similar to what he did in the second round. And I'm assuming it's just because he doesn't need as much money as the rest of the team, or probably has a bit more. But Spera's got a nice position there. He can actually flank the terrorist. Don't know how much damage he can do with the CZ, but he has to make a quick move. And if he's not careful, they might even hear him before he arrives. Bomb's going to be planted at the A site. Two players remaining here for the CTs, but it looks like it's yet another relatively clean round here. And Spera, he's going to try and run away with that AWP and save it.
That's huge, actually. If he's able to carry that over, because he probably doesn't have the money to buy an AWP into the next round. If Rowling can play this smart, yeah. See, they want to track down this AWP. They don't want to allow him to save it, but they've given up an AK now, too. Let the MAC-10 and the UMP hunt that. Why are you throwing AKs at this? I know that you have a shitload of money right now, Gambit, but this is just a little bit silly. You're throwing away economy for no real reason. You're going to have to go 3 rebuys into the next round. I understand, you know, we're 4 rounds in. 5th round is upon us. We are finishing this out with a 5-0 scoreline for Gambit. They farmed up a lot of money. But this could, I mean, if Kingwin string a couple rounds together, we could see the money kind of get wishy-washy down the road. But, you know, a lot of rounds left to be played. This MAC-10's going to go on the hunt. So close. And now so dead. Hobbit falls. The AWP gets saved. And they can actually drop a rifle over if they need to.
I think the main issue with that round was that Mo played completely insensitive to the fact that they might get exit frags and pick up that AWP. And that was the second time he's done that. So he needs to be careful, really, especially at the end of rounds. Okay, you've won the round. You know, you've got, you know, for sure you're going to get the round. The bomb's going to explode. But still, giving away an AWP like that to Spero could be a game changer for the next round. So he has to be a bit more careful. And he has to rebuy an AWP as well. So full buy once more from Gambit. And we have a double AWP set up here on Kingwin's side with Rallin picking up the AWP. I wonder if he's going to find a better form with it, because he wasn't looking too great against Rogue with that weapon, to be honest.
5-0. And at what point do you guys change your predictions out of interest?
Honestly, I was after the first... After they lost the pistol round and the 2 rounds after that, I was really thinking, man, you know, Gambit, look, they look on form on Cobble.
Well, it's one of two scenarios. Either Kingwin wins and it's close,
yeah,
or
exactly.
Gambit just completely slaughters.
Yeah, yeah, that is genuinely a real big possibility. But the rounds are coming
this
in.
This is going to be fan that stuff.
Oh, a spray down, but it's not going to work. Doja takes him down. Oof. Nate comes in. That's a nice little pick off, but they still need to keep the pressure on now. This is when it gets dangerous. Spero playing very, very up close and personal here. He's got a tight angle to cover. He will be able to find the kill. Taken down Mo. But the trade comes through. Hobbit finding one. Spero still
great
going,
flash.
But he's going to get taken down now. Hobbit in a 1v3. Makes it a 1v2. He's going to be able to reclaim the bomb. They know exactly where it was. They know what he's going to do, and he's got 30 seconds left. So he is that either has to go in frag hard or die hard.
Because
Marzinho is up close and personal. He's not going to check it, and he is going down.
Yeah, nicely managed there from the Kingwin side. And, you know, we talked about it before. The series that Mihu had against Rogue earlier to get him into this position into the Grand Finals, he was an absolute beast throughout that. All 3 maps, he top fragged for his team. He's going to happen to have another one of those all-star performances into this, and he's starting off 3-6. Granted, that was only the second rifle round that we've seen on the board so far in this matchup, but Kingwin are going to need to get at least 6 rounds, I feel, on this CT half if they want to be viable into this map. And that's the biggest part about it, is that you're also talking about Gambit getting up to 9, potentially more rounds than that. And they've already got 5 early in this half.
And especially if the reset comes in here, that's going to be deadly. Of course, 2 AWPs up on Kingwin. So they definitely have the cobblestone picking potential, but it's the kind of map where double AWP is either going to be insanely effective, like on Dust 2, or it's just not going to work out and you're going to get taken down because it's so easy.
I think it's a waste of money. I agree with you. I think it's a waste of money that Rallin's buying an AWP. He's not been good on it.
Underwhelming.
You know, he's been pretty underwhelming. It's just a waste of cash. It's better for him to get an M4 and just play any other position. We'll see, though. Spero's been good
playing
on it. And he's probably on the B site.
Yeah, he's playing back fountain.
But
on
the thing
B
is,
side.
What an AWP is very, very good at on cobblestone is wasting utility. But you can't do that with a double AWP because, you know, you're baiting out utility by showing the presence of the AWP, so they want to get close. But then you're still trying to AWP the position because you've got 2 AWPs. You're not going to change that position. If you've got 1 dynamic AWPer, you can be going around the place. You can be wasting that utility. You can be putting pressure on the enemy team. But when you've got 2 and they know it's a double AWP setup, as soon as they hear an AWP, they know it's going to be a static call. It's not going to move.
That's true. The other side of it, too, is if you do lose the bomb site, you've got to retake with the AWP. And that's nigh impossible once they take, even on the A bomb site, but even more so on the B bomb site. Mihu, though, going to be able to open up. Doja goes down, but they do trade effectively. Sparrow going to find one just as the smoke blooms. Takes down Hobbit. Mo finds Mihu, so the trade's going back and forth, but they've got site control. Zeus is going to get a forward position, finds Sparrow.
Exactly.
And now they've got two ops for this retake. Shouldn't happen.
I don't know why Fern is even Mo dropped. What is that? That is not a strat. That's really weird. I mean, he is going to find himself a kill there on Smoke.
You're proving you wrong, man.
Yeah, I know. But now Rallen picks up a UMP. Like,
that's all he
why?
Had. That's what Furlan had going into this.
That doesn't make any sense to me. He's going to find himself a weapon on the site, but it's already over. They're going to get taken down.
That was a bit of a little bit of a soup there. What I want to say is, like, look at this, right? Rallen, I think we can't judge the decision to get a double op too heavily, because I think the whole idea of the op on Rallen is for him to hold the B site. And we haven't seen a fast P push against that AWP yet. So it might be successful. It might be successful deterrent if they decide to go for the B side. But anyway, regardless, on the retake, they couldn't do the retake. For some reason, Furlan picked up the AWP, a Sparrow, and it just didn't work out. And so now they've lost the round. Their economy's been demolished. They tried to go for a little bit of a boost there. It didn't work. Full eco, and it should be yet another round for Gambit. And they're looking strong, Gambit, at the moment. Two MAC-10s. They know they're reading the economy well. They're going to make a lot more money now. And that's going to make sure that even if they do lose rounds, they'll still have plenty of money to buy weapons.
Worst part about this, too, is that things are just going to spiral out of control now for Gambit. They're just going to get completely way out of control as far as their round count is concerned. They're going to get the 7-1 after this is done. Another reset after this round is done, and you could be looking at a 9-1 scoreline. At that point, where does it stop? You could see a 14-1 scoreline by the end of it. It would be absolutely ridiculous down the road. And there you go. Look at all that money that's farmed up. Hobbit going to go to work.
Oh, yeah.
Look at that. 8-1 for Zeus, 10-3 for Adren. I mean, these guys, Zeus isn't even dying into these rounds. That's it. The only round that he died was the round that Kingwin won. You want to win the round? Kill Zeus. There you go.
That's the, that's how you do it. 7-1. Gambit looking tough, looking strong, looking ready. But we do see a full buy now from Kingwin. But Furlan picking up the UMP as well. I think Furlan really likes that weapon. I think he does pick it up a lot, does buy it a lot.
It's not paying off. That's the problem.
Well, I was gonna try and defend him, but you know what?
It's not paying off, because every time that he's had the ump, they've gone towards the A bomb site. This is where Doja is so deadly. He's bypassed the long A push. He's gotten himself into connector. He's going to be able to swing on these guys that are outside of the drop window. Furlan has absolutely no idea what's about to hit him. Boom,
yep,
dead.
There it is.
B bomb site compromised. Doja 2K. The B bomb site is open. He's even going to get a third before he falls. He cleared out the entire B bomb site. They've got complete control of the round now in a 2v4.
That is just so sloppy. Play 2 bend towards long if you're looking lower or if you've smoked it off. How can you do that? How can you let someone literally walk through your defense?
The same thing happened a few rounds ago with the Drin coming out through drop and getting in through the
connector.
You know, they
wiped out the AWP the first time they had it.
As soon as Spiro got an AWP, they dropped it. That was a round that they lost.
I think we have to accredit this to fatigue, because this is not how you would normally play. You can't be making these normal kind of mistakes in a final.
Or Gambit watched one of their previous matches on Cobblestone and saw that, hey, sometimes they go for this kind of a setup. Let's try pushing somebody in this position.
To be fair, though, they have been watching them all day.
They have.
They have been watching every single thing they do from downstairs.
And surfing and practicing and then playing a bit of
football. Yeah, I mean, exactly where they are, they have the screen next to them.
When you're playing against a sex god, you have to watch your behind. You have to watch your behind.
It's true.
It's a well-known, unwritten rule.
All day.
I've been watching my behind because of you, mate, because you're a predator. Just like the sponsors of this tournament, Predator.
I'm a master, mate. I'm a Predator master.
Are you the master of Predators?
Yeah.
Can I get a wall of cringe in chat, please?
Cringe, oh my God, cringe. It's so cringe.
Oh my God.
I'm Tom and I cringe at everything, lol, XD.
Fuck. What'd you call it? So yeah, that's the story behind this tournament. It's not actually about CS. It's about who is the master Predator out of the casters.
And it is, so far, Mega Man.
What the fuck?
That was a quick change, quick switch. Right.
I mean, I was going to say
He was expecting me to say Sonny, you know, he's looking at me like, yeah.
And we're back in the crapper.
Nice. Crapper.
Back in the crapper, man. 8-1, though, 9 rounds behind us, and this is what I was saying. Look at how it's spiraling out of control. Rallen, no armor, mag 7. Does have a decent nade kit behind him, but the rest of the team is on an abysmal buy. They save 2 AKs out of the last round, 2 FAMAS purchases going forward. This boost for Mo. Gets caught a little bit there, almost hits the shot, but a reset here for Kingwin, and you're looking at a 10-1 scoreline. They need to open up, and they will find that pick.
Just a spray through the smoke. Just a standard spray through the smoke. Just happens every once in a while. Get a headshot. Cool stuff.
Calling him out. Here we go. Watch Dozer. Same position again. This time not going to get a frag. Mihu takes him down.
Oh, he can't do anything. They've seen him, so he's just going to have to run away.
No armor as well.
Yeah, that fire would have roasted him.
Yeah, exactly. He can get taken down so easily.
Roast Rallen, my favorite dinner. Don't know about you, mate.
No.
Do you like roast Rallen?
No, mate.
Oi, listen. Do you know this guy's diet consists of bread and meat only. Doesn't eat anything else. Allergic to greens. That's Sonny.
Yeah, I've never had a salad in my life, honestly.
16 combined HP for the remaining of the Gambit players. They're going to try to push into this B-bomb site anyway, but maybe thinking wise of falling back just to hang on to the AWP. 1 HP for Mo to work with, now only 9 for Hobbit. So yeah, they're going to fall back from this one. Go up into Rapunzel and see if they can hang on to those. Mo's favorite place on this map.
Yeah, exactly. Mega Man remembered.
I remember you talked about being a scrub on pub servers and just going up and, I'm cool, I got an op, so I'm going to go up into the tower here.
Even worse. Just kill people.
When he was 50,
the thing is, you know what the funny is? Because we played on pubs, people don't care about like bomb planting and shit. So you'd get like CTs run up all the way to that position. You just kill them. That was fun, man. Good times. You never had that experience?
No, mate.
No? You're just straight into S rank ESCA. Like first game, boom.
I'm B-minus ranked on ESCA.
I'm MS.
Is that good or bad?
I am.
No, you're really not.
What about you?
Genuinely M rank is.
I think Bogdan might have something to say about that.
Hey?
8-2 is the scoreline going forward in this one. 6 rounds the difference. Gambit finally forced to use some of their economy as Kingwin's going to be able to pick up that second round now, but they're going to have to clean house for the rest of this half if they want any chance of going into the second half, because the way that it looks, Zeus and Adrin came to play. Mo's going to be on point with the AWP. There's that crack shot that you were talking about before that he was looking through with the AWP.
Yeah.
He's going to go ahead and push him back with that Molotov and try to get a little bit extra out of this. Misses the timing. Does take a little bit of a chunk down from that HE grenade, but he's going to reposition, try to pound himself a little bit more of an angle. That nade, that's a lot of damage.
No fear, my brother. Mo. He's going to be forced back due to that smoke. Good play here from Michu. He's got no support, though. He has to be careful. He dies there. They've lost the man advantage. Rallen's just going for an auto shotgun now. He's just saying, F it.
I don't understand what is happening.
I don't care. I love it.
When I get real tilted,
where's
Rallen
playing? I assume that he's
probably dropper.
Yeah, he's got to be playing from drop room with an auto shotgun, and he is.
I mean, Observer's on point, though. He's listening to our cast, and he's changing plays. I love him.
He's got it.
Godspeedy.
Yeah, he's on it.
Every time.
Question mark.
There is a push somewhat low. There's 3 players. Yeah, look at Spiro.
Meech is backed away. Smart idea.
Yeah, they don't want to give anything away early into the round. Just pop a shot in mid. Hobbit, they're going to rotate back over towards the B-bomb site. They've got to deal with the player in the back lines here. See what they can do, but the push is coming in, and it is going to be a dry peak. There's no utility being thrown out here from the terrorist side. There's actually no utility that they have. Ferlin's going to hit a nice ripper there. Looking for the double up. He's not going to be able to find it. Michu does manage to find Zeus, but Mo answers the call with the AWP frag onto Michu. That is going to leave it on Ferlin to try to come around. He's found a second.
This is actually the first time I've heard the new...
Now Doja.
That's the first time I've heard the new sounds for the old shotgun. Ever. I've never heard that gun with the new sounds.
Can we get an update to Moobot, by the way? Pansy's not even here anymore.
Yes, she is. She's down there, chilling.
She's certainly not.
Pansy, there. If you can hear me, come.
She's not a dog. Come.
That's not how you call for dogs.
How do you call for
come. Here, boy. Here, boy.
That's a cat.
Here, boy.
That's a cat.
What? You don't say boy, here, boy, to cats.
You
cats do not listen to you. You don't bother talking to cats. Just mate, F off.
So over it. 3 rounds now for King. When they're starting to battle back a little bit. See if they can chip away a little bit more moving forward. They'll already take down to 32. And that 5 round difference, though, is still quite a bit.
Up on Mo. You know what? Mo's not been playing well at all. My opinion. I think he's got a couple of frags, but he's not been doing good. Not as
like
I expected.
6 or 7 kills, I think.
Yeah, but.
I mean, he's not really
like
the hard
eco
carry.
Bashes and stuff. Like he's not, but he should be landing better shots. He should be winning his 1v1s versus Spero XYZ. But it doesn't matter because the rest of his team are doing pretty well. Zeus, like you said earlier, didn't die too much. Adren, as usual, carrying. He's going to try and find an entry towards the B site. The bomb's rotating all the way, but it's on its own. They have to be careful. I mean, if one CT decides to push to get information, he might even drop the bomb. Hobbit takes down Rallen towards Dropper. So that's Dropper taking. Look at this. Ferlin is an absolute hero. 2 kills for him. But he finally goes down to Moe's P250.
That's a Glock.
Or a Glock.
Very bad read there from Mu. It's all going to come down to Zeus. 1 versus 2. 30 seconds to play with. But he hasn't got himself a bomb site, thanks to his teammate going down. A very slow rotation from the CTs into this round. When Furlan was getting those two kills, he even turned it into a third, I believe. No, it wasn't. It was just a two. But no team to be seen. And so they let him die. Unfortunately, it was very low, though. So forgive him, of course. Now he's got a good read. Looking for the second, but he's not reading it quite well enough.
Shapiro gave away his spot with the AWP.
8 seconds remain now. He's going to go for this bomb plant just in the nick of time.
And that smoke was actually really, I don't know if he meant to throw it like that, but it was good because it covered his fallback from double doors. So that means Shapiro can't get that secondary position and try to find him. Now it's AK versus AK, and Zeus gets the clutch.
Quick.
3 kills, 3 versus 1, and Zeus gets it done.
That's experience. That's experience for you. Really well played by Zeus, actually. Played it very smart.
11-4 for Zeus right now, doing some work for his team. And he's continuing to stack those rounds up for the Gambit side. Nicely played from Zeus.
Yeah, very, very nice round there. And I don't know if that smoke was an accident, but it was perfect.
He definitely put on double doors so he can plant the bomb without somebody shooting him from behind. Yeah.
It's a very nice bit of play. And once again, Kingwin going to have a very difficult economical situation. If they lose this round, it'll be it for the rest of the half. They'll have no money for the last two rounds. Rallin trying to get himself a kill through, but it's not going to work out. Instead, he's going to get tagged up. Rallin going low, but he will find the kill in the end. And so, advantage in the hands of Kingwin into this one. Still, they're 9 rounds down already. They're already only having the opportunity to get themselves 6 rounds in this half on their CT side of Cobble. And that is definitely not a good way to be going into it.
No, yeah, my feeling both teams are like T-sided on this map, to be honest. I think both of them get more rounds on the T-side.
Yeah, we'll see.
So I wouldn't discount Kingwin yet.
I did say that Kingwin needed to get 6 rounds on their CT side.
Oh, dead man. Oh, sorry. Mega Man, dead man.
Dead man.
Sorry, I had to sneeze and I couldn't get to my microphone boom in time to move it. Finally got there. Pardon me, guys. 6 rounds being the difference.
Bless
Gambit.
You.
Thank you.
I'm blessed.
I woke up with a little bit of a head cold this morning, so
head
hopefully.
Cold?
Yeah, head cold.
How does a head cold?
It's a head cold. Shut up, I'm American.
It's what you get when a trend just absolutely
Gambit.
Demolishes
yeah, it's
the beast
site.
And now they're going to save the weapons. Very nicely done. He completely switched that around.
Eh, not quite.
Head to toe. Bombs planted. Another round, 10-3. Kingwin having to save. But yeah, you know what? They had the man advantage, and all of a sudden, Adrenaline with 2 entries, and it's rest in peace.
Molly entry as well. I believe that was over to Chicken Coops, finding that entry frag. And this is where things are continuously getting more and more scary for Kingwin. I mean, they're going to go down to a 10-3. Double digits already acquired for Gambit. Zeus even taking a gun out of their hands. Is me who continues to try to push on forward. Spiro going to be your last man standing in a 1v3. And he's just trying to hold on to that AWP. I mean, they absolutely need some of these players to step up. Mihu especially, he's the guy that's been doing the hard carrying for them throughout this series, throughout this tournament. And, well, they're even going to lose the AWP in the end. Doja does manage to get it done, and they will go up 10-3.
So are you guys ready to change your predictions?
Well, you can't really.
You said 16-12, didn't you?
I said 16-12 for Kingwin, yeah. That's,
I mean,
it's
they
like
could do that now.
I also did say that either Kingwin was going to win close or Gambit was going to blow him away.
But that was
it wasn't going to be.
That was after
one down.
Right?
They were 6-1 down when you said that.
That was 3-0 when I said that.
We have a VOD. We do have a VOD.
Yeah, it's fine. Go back and look at it. It was
3-0. I don't have that much time in my life.
No, obviously, it wouldn't be a very good, you know, it wouldn't be a prediction if I keep changing it. So it's just me, you know, changing my mind.
Yeah,
to the reality of the world, which is Gambit absolutely demolishing Kingwin.
Once
now.
It's wrong,
it's not a prediction anymore, is it?
No.
It's just me agreeing. Yeah, well, Gambit just won.
No, you're agreeing that I am right. That's what you're
doing. Oh, my God. He gets one prediction right.
About? Sorry.
And he's not going to be quiet forever.
Hang on a second. I have basically predicted everything right.
No, oh, yeah? Really? We've got VODs for that.
Yeah,
mate.
First day, first game. Was I not right?
Oh,
straight out of the bat.
I think I was. Rallin going to be able to find the Refringe frag, takes down the Hobbit. Equalizes things onto the 4v4. It is a save round here, and he only managed to
full
get a
flash.
Mag 10 out of that. And there's the push around. Rallin finding a second one. Does have a Mag 10 to play with, but here you go, man.
That's a good crossfire setup there.
Kingwin doing
the
some work into this one on the pistols. They do have the flank as well. Shapiro coming around from the back line. CZ in hand as well. And now he's going to start pushing in Zeus, though. Managing to find one. Does get dinked down, so they are low. Let's see what they can do from this. Adren's going to have to be the hero.
Ugh, what is going on here? Wow. Adren saves it. Last
Why am I not
second,
surprised?
1v3. Why are you not surprised at what?
That Adren clutches it.
Because he's a really good player.
Yeah, he's super
really
consistent.
So why does Thorin keep calling him a decoy? Ooh, shots fired.
Why are you
fired.
Trying to go there? Man. It's not. He's talking about a different adrenaline. He's talking about the adrenaline that was public with the US adrenaline.
Ah, you're so funny, man.
I know.
So
I'm aware.
I was going to think, like, I've never heard that, but.
You suck.
Yeah, I do.
You suck.
Dick.
I did Ooh, not look at this. Say that.
That's pretty nasty what you just said there, but it's a really fast push by Gambit towards the A site. Trade of kills.
They should be aware they haven't cleared long as well, so they're going to play it on long.
Yeah, I think they're pretty aware of that.
Well,
but
you see most
look at this rotation.
I like the change of pace, too, from Gambit. They've been going very slow in the past couple of rounds. This time they just rushed towards A. And working out okay.
Oh,
I mean, a Dren extended spray. Yeah, he's got 3 kills into the round, and Hobbit going to be able to secure one more. There's the flank for Miku.
Oh.
Just managed to find 2. Going to be looking for Hobbit. Only 10 HP remains, and they know that he's in the pit. So this is going to be definitely clutchable. He's going to actually flank the flanker, flanking the flank. So he's going to come back around through long haul. And
oh, he has no idea. Oh, he jumps. Oh, he just gives away his position.
Yeah, but now he can play mind games with him. It's got to be a 10-second defuse. So Miku trying to be the hero. And look at this. Stalwart from Hobbit knows that he's got to go for the full defuse. He's counting the seconds, spots that he's not on the bomb. There goes the peak. And I don't think Mihu's going to have time for this. So he's going to have to pick up the AWP and run away.
It's the last round of the half.
Yep, it doesn't matter. He's dead. 12-3, Gambit.
I think that's probably what one of the Polish guys said, probably just to Miku now, except in a different accent or different language, maybe.
Last fucking round, man. Vysev. Trap AVP.
Nie dobry. Nie dobre. Nie dobra. Nie dobrze.
Trap
AVP. Nine Dobran.
Trap AVP Rajbi.
It's not Polish.
No, it's not.
That's not Polish either.
I know it's not.
O, spierdawaj. Ja pierdo. Głupi.
Das wydaje.
That's Russian.
I know.
But that was smart by Hobbit.
That was. He played that perfectly in the 1v1.
Is he short? Is he the short guy?
Yeah.
Is that
obviously.
Why he calls himself Hobbit?
Hobbit, no, he's that one. He's not that short.
He's the shortest.
He doesn't look like a Hobbit either.
You know what? Doja's actually deceptively tall.
Yeah, I never realized that he was that tall, but he's like 6'2".
He's a big man.
Yeah, he's a tall guy. Man, he's hot as hell though.
Yeah.
He's a good looking dude.
Lol, I don't even know what people are laughing at now.
They're laughing at the not attempting the defuse on the final round.
No, that happened, and then some. I think somebody said something, and now everyone's laughing. I think it's Polish people laughing at the bad Polish.
Yeah, I did say fuck you, you fuck.
Did you say that?
Stupid.
In
yeah,
Polish,
very badly, very very
Go on,
badly.
Say it again.
No,
it's been you said. Didn't say it. I You're did. Lying.
Ja pierdoles, spierdalaj, głupi.
Cool. So second half of this one is going to be a 9-round difference.
That sounds rough.
Just out of this mix right now. I mean, they look flat-footed. They look defeated. They look tired. And, I mean, rightfully so. They had a very long series with
What, five
Rogue
hours
earlier.
Was it? 6 hours?
It was a long one. It was a long one.
Long match.
Show Doja.
It's a family show.
If we show Doja, it's going to break. Oh, there you go. All right. You got your taste, Doja. Can we take the camera off Doja before everybody
Can we zoom in?
Blind?
Oh, there's no cameraman.
There is no cameraman. I'll go up there and do it. Second half is upon us, though, so the pistol round going to kick off. Gambit securing a pistol round victory here is all but going to shore up map one.
What do you think the score is going to be, Sonny?
16-5.
Do you think King would pick up the pistol round?
16-5 to
you. Or do you think it's going to be that they have like a little bit, a little bit of a last-ditch effort going into the gun rounds?
If Gambit pick up the pistol round, it'll be 16-5. That's your prediction.
Are all you right? mad? If Gambit pick up the pistol round.
You're immense.
Are
I thought you said it,
mad?
If, I thought you said if King would pick up the pistol round, I was like, you what?
Yeah. No, mate. You're off your rails.
Ooh, two players with utility. Ferlin and Rallin. They're taking it easy, though. Nothing fast from them this round. And the CTs are pretty spread out. 2B, 2A, one dropper, holding quite distance position. And it's good. USP is much better in long distances than the Glock. Look at this, CZ though on Zeus, and he's probably the closest one to any action at the moment. 3 terrorists jumping up and down here. They're making a lot of noise, and the CTs aren't really responding to that, which is good because, you know, sometimes people do that. They go there at long, they'll run about, they'll jump about, and sometimes force their rotation from the CTs to go to A. But now they go back towards the B site, and they're going slowly, and Adren, he's going to get the first contact from the Ts.
Do you have a good bit of gambling today?
You know what? I was all right. I won some money.
Oh, well,
fake money, not real money.
Oh, that's a bit sad. Anyway, the push is coming in. Adren is going to be a dead man, and the rotate will follow. Mihu diving over Hobbit, but Hobbit going to be saved by Doja. They do go down in the end, so it's a 2v4 retake. Make that one. It's all on Zeus. 1 versus three now, as he does find himself a single kill. But he hasn't got enough ammo to win this round unless he finds an alternative weapon system. The CZ is not... What?
Hey, listen, why'd you say Zeus like that?
Zeus. Zeus.
You say it like... Are you taking a mick out of someone, or is this literally how you say
Zeus? That's how Eastern European people say Zeus.
Oh, so you are taking a mick out of Eastern Europeans?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
Why not? Yeah.
There you go. I knew it. So if you're you know, at home and you're watching a Greek movie with Zeus in it, you'd say Zeus. You wouldn't say Zeus, would you? I'm watching Zeus. I'm all right.
12-4 is the scoreline now. Gambit in the lead by 8 rounds, but the pistol round victory putting Kinguin into a position where they can at least chip away at this a little bit. UMP close range, gonna fail. Moe's gonna find that. They did invest in the head armor and upgraded pistols. Is he going to toss that over? No, he couldn't actually get up close enough to retrieve that UMP for the time being. But they're going to double team him. Spiro's going to go down, and Zeus going to get the assist mode with the second frag of the round. Now they can actually retrieve some stuff here, but Ferlin pushed up in middle. He's going to be able to take down a Drain. Looking for a little bit more. Desert Eagle going to do some damage. Rowland's going to be low. Hobbit finishing off Ferlin. That's going to leave it in a 2v3. Salvaged AK as well as UMP in the hands now of Gambit. We'll see if they can do anything moving forward. This is a good forward position. Only one down, though. It's all on Mal's.
And don't forget, they've got armor to play. So this is basically two fully brought up players. There it is. Gambit Gaming straight back in. They're not out until they're out.
Absolutely not. And there's the answer back. You might actually get your 16-5.
Yeah, I know. That's because I'm very good at my job.
They will have an opportunity.
Yeah? Is your job making predictions?
It should be.
Really?
Yep. I had it here first. Mate, I used to go on CSGO Lounge and win money.
Did you?
Yeah. Long time
ago. Semi don't believe you.
I lost a lot. But
just semi.
But no, I always used to bet on Fnatic back when they were really, really insane. Like before ProNex left, like a month or two before that, they used to win every single game, like everything.
You made loads of skins, yeah?
Oh, I made like almost
a grand. You were the problem in CS.
I almost made a grand off that, except I lost when they lost to CLG.
Oh.
I lost 400 quid in one day.
So that's a quick change of fate, winning an eco round. Pistols, taking out Kinguin.
No, it's skill.
Well, it was a force buy, too. I mean, Gambit put all their eggs in the basket. Mo, though, nice read. Might get two. Going to take another one low. That's Rallin down to 36. Still firing through. He's getting chipped down. He's going to have to fall back from this one. Actually, Zeus getting knocked down to 42 as well through that smoke. So, I mean, this is a reinvestment, a full buy from the Kinguin side. See if they can do anything behind this, but this is a pretty decent start to the round from both sides. You can see the AK getting swapped over. Rowland being low, going to go to the lesser substantial Galil. I'd actually like to see, well, Spiro doesn't have body armor behind this. Ferlin's on an AK with no armor. I'm okay with this. Spiro can lead the charge, spearhead the assault. Rowland can go in second, get traded in Ferlin, and Malz can try to trade back and see how things go from there, but now it is going to be the push out. One player on Humpty Dumpty going to get knocked back, and Rallin is going to come around the corner. Adren drops. And now things get a little bit more tricky here for the Gambit boys, but Doja doing his best, as well as Malz equaling, and now taking the advantage right back. Malz finding two more kills. That's going to leave it on Ferlin. 1v3.
Yeah, there's not too much he can do. He will find himself the opening frag, but he's already getting tagged down through the smoke. And he's got two players to contend against. He has got the bomb in hand, so timing is definitely not in his favor, Mike.
That reload. He moved it just at the last moment.
8 seconds. Oh, he's dead. What on earth is Humpty Dumpty?
Humpty Dumpty is the little half wall that you can boost on top of.
Why?
What do you mean, why?
Why? Why do you call it that?
Because typically, if you get spotted, you get killed and you fall off of it, like Humpty Dumpty when he fell off the
wall. Did you make that?
No, pretty much every caster that's worth his salt calls it Humpty Dumpty.
That's not true.
That's actually completely true.
Wow, shots fired.
That is not true. Mo, what do you call it?
Do some research.
Don't call it Humpty Dumpty. But Tech 9 and armor with utility. Yes, that's excellent, Mega Man.
Two versus one.
Make fun of the casters with you. Just. Oh, no comment. Hobbit here. Holding B. It's got two people supporting him. Seems like Kinguin are getting ready for a fast B with quite a lot of utility, smokes, flashes, and tech nines.
Hey, Pansy, what do you call the wall people boost up on? Cold Zero was the first one to boost up onto it on Cobblestone. Titanic? No. The one on A-bomb site where you're looking down the hill. So you don't call it Humpty Dumpty? Well, that's
supposedly
weird. That's really weird.
Supposedly you're a caster not worth your salt.
Bad luck. Bad luck, Pansy.
I am either. So.
Don't worry, none of us are.
Like join the club.
Wow, what a round.
Clean up by Ferlin, four kills.
You off. So
14-5 now. We are going to see a save come out from Gambit. So Kingwin with an opportunity here to pick up a couple more. See what they can do behind this, but it's going to be a struggle. It's going to be the full pistol save from them. Gambit. I mean, Kingwin's still well on the back foot right now, but it's going to have to be some magnificent pistol play from Gambit again if they want to steal away another round from him.
You know what I'm thinking?
What?
Your prediction's wrong.
No, I'm not.
I don't know if Gambit wins.
Oh, yeah,
round,
no. Yeah, it's probably not going to be right, but I don't really care.
Well, then again, my prediction's wrong as well. But I didn't say, well, I did say the score. I said 16-13. Still.
Nope, Mo got the first kill. So already the man advantage. Zeus is going to find one as well. Mouse does answer the call, though. Hobbit Furlan going to go in on two as well, and that is going to leave it down to Zeus, who salvages the UMP down the bottom pit. And Doja managing to take another one with him to the grave. One HP for Furlan. This position from Zeus, though, he's going to be able to find one. It's going to be 18 HP versus one. And can we see Harold strike back here?
Why, God? Why do this to me?
Oh, throw the spam out. Come on, Zeus. Letting him up on the site.
It's not this is not justice. It's not fair. It really is not fair. I should have kept quiet. I really should have kept quiet.
Using the half wall for cover, though, Zeus.
You could blow on Furlan.
Oh, yes.
Get in, Furlan. Come on, lad. Bring it home. 4K.
So close.
Not a biased caster.
So close.
It was close.
As always, next, yep.
Yeah. Oh, why have you got chips?
I found them.
You thief. They're probably missing loads of money.
Yeah. I've stolen it all.
Don't ask asking how much HP. No reply. No
one
replying to the X-God. Wow.
That's un.
I would not expect that.
I mean, he might just get him after this. He might just X on him.
Nice spam from mid door, though. That's going to find one. Rallin with the UMP. Put it to work against Zeus, finding him right with a shot between the eyes, and that's going to leave it on four players now for Gambit. Kingwin still with their back against the wall, but they're going to have to fight out of this tooth and nail.
Everyone knows that Dosey got ignored. Oh dear. Another anti eco. That will be for Kingwin's benefit. Seven rounds for them. But I think Gambit. Ooh. Well, Adrenge pops out of nowhere.
He's very good.
You know what? Whatever I say, the opposite just happens.
Just
immediately, I'm like, oh, it's just an easy eco round. Adrenge's like, okay, is that what you're saying? Four kills for Adrenge. Is he going to make it an ace? I can't believe it. Oh, on an eco run as well. Furlan's down to two health.
Three HP on the
board.
Throw
anything you've got in your hand. Throw that smoke. No, do something.
Oh, oh my God.
Furlan. Why, Furlan?
My God.
Why did
every
you ruin that?
Time.
Mate, there is. I'm not going to speak. I can't cast. Whatever I say, just the opposite happens. Just Adrenge walks in and starts killing everyone. And look at the position he was in as well. It was like the most awkward place to be in. Oh, my God. Adrenge.
So close.
Replay that. We need to replay that. That was pretty sick.
And that shot that he hit down mid, too, when he got the AK, was ridiculous. It was like a 180 shot, headshot, instant kill for his third frag of the round. That was awesome. What a hero effort. The worst part about it, though, is Kingwin. That's two rounds in a row that it's come down to a 1v1.
On
and
an
they have no money. So they're going to go back. Yeah, look at how much money they have on the terrorist side. They've won like three rounds in a row, and they have nothing to show for it as far as economy is concerned. So seven rounds being the difference, but one round one from Gambit is going to ruin the economy for the terrorist side. And, I mean, they're on a knife's edge right now.
It says a lot when you have two really, really close anti-eco rounds. I mean, on a buy round, you know, it doesn't favor you. It simply doesn't favor you. So AWP now on Mo. Rifles for the rest of the team. Utility left on Zeus. I think the CT has already used up quite a bit of the utility that they had. But on the other hand, the terrorists only have three smokes. Well, it's good enough for a B push if they want to do that. But nothing for the after plant situations. And look at this. I think the CTs might one of them. I think it's Zeus who might be going a bit higher up to get some information. But no, he's just going to stay there. They're getting ready for a B push. They're only, you know, arguably there's only one CT really on the B site at the moment. Two and dropper. It could be a bit of a disaster here for Gambit. Unless Hobbit can hold them off. He's relatively flashed here. See his 1T. Furlan will cut him down. And they will push forward, finding the entries. Furlan completely whiffing his shots. Adrenaline will pick up two with Dosia in support. And it's a very fast rotation here from the CTs. Rallin and Michu remaining. 10 seconds left in the clock. The bomb needs to be planted very soon. Mo takes down Michu. And there you have it.
Yeah,
very, very fast rotation. I mean, look at the beginning of that round, after taking down Hobbit, they should have won that. I mean, bomb planted, throw down your smokes, cut them off, and just hold. But it's a really, really fast rotate from Gambit.
That's going to be the game right there. They're going to be looking to map number two in this one because there's hardly anything that, Kingwin, I mean, they could barely even win an anti-eco round against Gambit, let alone the full gun round comes out and they keep three players alive on the Gambit side moving forward. So pretty good spot for Gambit to be in. Like I said, losing 8 guns in the past two rounds, or actually 13 guns in the past 3 rounds for Kingwin has really set them back economic-wise, and they are going to be on a very difficult buy moving forward. Not a rifle to be seen. Decent utility and armor on all the players, but firepower advantage obviously in the hands of Gambit right now. That meat's not going to help things either, as Ferlin's going to go down to 53 to start this one off in the drop room.
I'm just really annoyed that Sonny's right and we're wrong.
Well,
that's the only thing that's in my mind at the moment. That's all.
Mate, you just
about.
Need to accept, all right, that this game can go either way at any time. It is never a done deal. And
are you consoling me now?
I am, yes.
Oh, thanks.
I'm just a bit of a nice guy.
Thanks.
All right, but on this day,
give me a
list. Gambit. Don't forget, Gambit. Gambit have been practicing all day. They've been warming themselves up. They, you know, they've been waiting for this game for a long, long time. Whereas Kingwin have been playing as hard as they can. They've managed to edge out the win over Rogue, and they've got to be tired by this.
They're tired. They're definitely tired.
Nice little tag through the wall there.
2-0. Cobblestone, 16-7, as Gambit capitalize.